As outsourcing in Africa's ICT sector continues to boom, service providers are developing new and innovative ways to offer their clients better outsourcing options. One of these includes the option of multi-sourcing. Here to discuss the concept and where it fits into the outsourcing industry is John Jenkins, Executive Director at Business Connexion.
Hi, Natasha.
John, welcome to the show. Now, can you set the scene for us? What is the fundamental difference between single sourcing and multi-sourcing?
Good. Thanks. Well, multi-sourcing is really where one would put a bundle of services together from and potentially a number of service providers, each who would offer the best in class or best in breed in their area, to form a service catalog for your organization. Where single sourcing would be, you would need to find a service provider that gave you best in breed in one house for all of those services, and that's difficult to do, especially in the African continent.
Now, from a business perspective, what are the advantages of making use of multi-sourcing?
Well, you know, especially with moves in technology towards things like cloud, the role that the mobile is playing specifically in Africa, the advantages would be that you can go to the market, choose one or two major service providers that have the full service as a package when you put it together, and then negotiate good pricing, negotiate good services from a best of breed perspective.
Now, speaking of negotiations, when you do have a multi-source provider, they essentially have many functions, everything from telephony to web-based, anything you can think of. How important does the negotiations become between yourself as a service provider and the client, and where does the SLA or service lease agreement come into here?
Well, I think what we're seeing is that traditionally one would have been negotiating on a set of technical SLAs. The problem is then the organization needs to have some fairly good skills in terms of being able to pull these together to form a business service, because really today businesses want a business service, not a set of technical SLAs. So what we're finding is organizations often call on somebody like ourselves, say, to be what they call a guardian vendor or an aggregate vendor, and let them use their expertise in service management and so on to take a set of business requirements, turn that into a set of underpinning technical SLAs, and then go and negotiate and contract for those on behalf of the organization, so they get sort of the best of both worlds.
Who do you deal with when conducting these SLAs? Because people immediately assume when it comes to the technical side of a business, that's your IT department. But that's not the same in this case, is it?
Well, what we find is that smart organizations will involve a group of people from the business that clearly understand the business needs and their internal IT organization, and of course more and more these days the commercial people as well. And between that team, they come up with a construct of what's needed at what price and the trade-off to find what's best, and then that's generally who we deal with. But business has to be a part of that process, or you land up maybe with a set of technical skills and not what the business really needs appropriately.
Now, you've previously touched on Africa. Now, in the African context, how viable has multi-sourcing become?
Well, I think multi-sourcing is most probably more viable in a lot of areas than just a single outsource. But the prime contractor or guardian vendor is an important role, because they can bring those skills to help you do that multi-sourcing. Multi-sourcing in itself is not an easy thing to do, but you know, if you get the right partner to help you with that, then it's viable. The interesting thing is that although multi-sourcing has become much more of a way of doing things in Europe and the States, we're finding that about 80% of deals in Africa and Middle East are still tending to be single supplier outsourcing. And I think it's because of this: get somebody that you can trust to do that and let them do the multi-sourcing for you.
Now, you mentioned multi-sourcing, even out of the African context, is not an easy service. Of course, that means if you do have it, that I suppose it comes at a premium. Is that a valid assumption to make? Because, well, essentially you're going into uncharted territory, setting up everything from the ground up and offering that service.
Well, In a multi-sourcing, at least you can go to a few of the players that have something there and wrap it. So what would come at a bit of a premium is that service integration layer, that service management layer. But we find that because of the skills that would reside in that capability, they can normally do a pretty good deal at the subcontractor level and still deliver a good deal. But of course it becomes a trade-off not just between price, it also becomes risk, capability at an acceptable price. And I think that's the sort of trade-off that's important.
Now, John, you're one of the multi-source providers now operating in the continent. You've just opened an office in Kenya. How is that going, and how are you guys planning to embark and spread your footprint across the continent?
Well, it's early days in Kenya, and we're taking it a little bit carefully. We've decided on a different strategy to maybe what some of the other organizations have done. We've looked at what's available, and our strategy now for Africa is much more one of go in, spend the time dealing with a few of the major corporates, secure a outsourcing contract, put some skills in that can, from South Africa, that can bring our way of work, or as we call it, our sort of tribal knowledge, and bring those skills, do the skills transfer, and then sell into some other organizations, rather than go and buy something which really doesn't exist, and then you spend all your time having to try and remorph it into a proper outsourcing organization. So we're engaging with a number of big organizations there. They're entertaining proposals from us, and hopefully soon we'll be up and running with a nice outsourcing deal there and then build from that.
And soon hopefully we can do a follow-up and see how you guys are doing.
Very much so.
John Jenkins, Executive Director at Business Connection, thank you very much.
Natasha, thank you.